Hi everyone. So today I wanted to take a little bit of a look at a topic in physics which is notoriously difficult, and that is the topic of general relativity. It's a topic that builds on a lot of the work from Einstein back from 1915, in which gravity is described as being a geometric property of space-time. There's a lot of math involved in the topic and a lot of really cool ideas as well. I was recently watching a YouTube lecture by Leonard Susskind about general relativity, and he starts off by saying that
general relativity has a reputation for being very difficult. I think the reason is that it's very difficult.
So today in this video, I just wanted to take a little bit of a peek at the topic to see what gives it this reputation, and for people who have never really encountered general relativity, give you an idea of what it's all about. You can see if it lives up to its reputation. And maybe this video will even give you a little bit of inspiration to want to go and learn the topic yourself. Of course, I don't have enough time in this video to really teach you general relativity, so we're just going to have a little glance at it. And the way that we're going to do that is by just having a look through some lecture notes that I have here. In fact, this is actually a summary of lecture notes. It's called a No-Nonsense Introduction to General Relativity by Caltech Professor Sean Carroll. And it's a summary of Sean Carroll's lecture notes for when he would teach this as an entire course. And those notes themselves have been adapted into a full textbook. But I think that this little summary of notes will be more than enough for us today. I think these notes will be a great place to start because Sean Carroll is a great science communicator. He's been like the scientific advisor for the Avengers films and done lots of work in that space. I wanted to take a moment to mention that Sean Carroll is actually coming to do his first ever tour of Australia and New Zealand in late February this year, and I'm able to offer my viewers 15% off tickets, so I'll leave the link down in the description if you would like to come along, and if you do, you can enter the code Tibees on the website to get that discount. That is thanks to Think Inc., the company that Sean is touring with, and they've toured other people around Australia and New Zealand, such as Brian Greene, Lisa Randall, and Neil deGrasse Tyson. Sean's doing this tour on the back of releasing his latest book, and he's going to be talking about the multiverse and the nature of reality, so it sounds pretty interesting. And with that, let's have a little bit of a look at general relativity. So the first page starts off with a bit of an introduction that immediately addresses that general relativity, or GR, is difficult. And it says it's mainly for two reasons. One is that tensors are everywhere, and two is that space-time is curved. These two facts force people in GR to use a different language than everyone else, which makes the theory pretty inaccessible. However, it claims that it is possible to grasp the basics of the theory. It sums up GR in two statements. One is that space-time is a curved pseudo-Riemannian manifold with a metric signature. And two, the relationship between matter and the curvature of space-time is contained in this equation, which has become a bit of a famous equation, Einstein's equation, although it is very difficult to understand unless you understand the notation. And most of the rest of these notes is doing just that, trying to get people to a point where they can actually understand this equation. And I would agree, it's not easy. The notes go on then to cover special relativity, which it's more likely that you have heard of and encountered already. Special relativity is often taught at the end of high school or in undergraduate because the math that's involved is actually not too hard. You need some Pythagoras and the ability to grasp things like time dilation and length contraction. It says that special relativity stems from considering the speed of light to be invariant in all reference frames. Usually when you encounter special relativity for the first time, you don't encounter it in the form of four vectors, but that's what we go on to have to learn here. See, we have four components of our x vector, including t, x, y, and z. So we have three spatial components and one time component. All four of these components making up space-time. All of our vectors in space-time will be four vectors, including a special one, the metric, which gives us a way of taking the dot product of two vectors. The next few pages discuss ideas such as the space-time interval, proper time, four velocity, which is velocity using four vectors, and likewise a momentum four vector. We discuss the idea of time-like and space-like with respect to light cones. In the light cone, the edges of the cone here represent traveling at the speed of light. Once you get to the topic of tensors, it kind of becomes make or break for you because they're really important. It says here that tensors may be thought of as objects like vectors, which transform under a change of coordinates according to the following rule called tensor transformation law. So tensors are really useful when you need to do changes of coordinates. But why would we be doing changes of coordinates in general relativity? Sort of, you know, what are we up to here? Well, one of the big ideas in general relativity is the equivalence principle. And I guess it says that in some situations, you won't be able to tell the difference between gravity and acceleration. For example, if you're in an elevator, both the effects of gravity and the effects of acceleration would feel the same to you. So sometimes we have to wonder if space-time has a real gravitational field or if we're just experiencing the effects of acceleration. And the question of whether space-time has a real gravitational field is similar to asking whether a geometry is flat. It was the problem worked on in mathematics by Riemann, so hence Riemannian geometry that we mentioned in the introduction. Essentially, if you're unable to do a coordinate transform that could make your geometry flat, then it is curved. So we need to understand how things transform when you make coordinate transformations. And that is why we care about tensors and tensor analysis. It's a difficult topic and I don't have much time to really explain tensors more, but we'll just have a little flick through the pages so at least you can see what we're dealing with. On this page, tensors are used to shrink Maxwell's equations into just two relations, which generalize to curved space-time and are the equations which govern the behavior of electromagnetic fields in general relativity. GR is a theory of gravity and of geometry, so it's important to understand what we mean when we talk about curvature and manifolds. Here it says basically a manifold is a possibly curved space which, in small enough regions, looks like flat space. The important thing about manifolds is that they have the same dimensionality everywhere. Dimensionality would be like 2D, 3D, 4D, something like that. So a piece of string attached to a plane would not be a manifold since it's partly one-dimensional and partly two-dimensional. If we had a real gravitational field around an object, say this is some kind of planet and this is the gravitational field, then we would expect to experience tidal forces on an object that is out here. Say this is a person, then because of the direction of the gravitational force is not purely horizontal but has a downwards vertical component here and a slightly upwards vertical component here, the object in here would actually be slightly squished. Or maybe a lot squished, I don't know. So you'd be squished or stretched by tidal forces, and that can indicate that you do have a true gravitational field. We could help to identify tidal forces by calculating a curvature tensor and defining our geometry as flat, where the curvature tensor is zero everywhere. Gravity is essentially equal to having curvature. Towards the end here, we encounter the Schwarzschild solution. It says here that the Schwarzschild metric is the unique solution to Einstein's equation in a vacuum with a spherically symmetric matter distribution. So this is perhaps a slightly more physical interpretation that we can use to kind of understand what's going on out there in space. There are a couple of places where this solution does have singularities. They would be at r equals to 0 and r equals to 2 gm. From what I know, modern research in general relativity seems to be doing things like trying to quantize general relativity or to find and apply numerical solutions to things like black holes. The numerical solutions mean you basically put in a lot of numbers and try to find out what would happen from certain initial conditions, try to play the equations forward in time. Quantum field theory, or QFT, is another very hard and notoriously difficult area of physics. And of course, the interface between GR and QFT is very difficult and, I guess, attracts people who are really interested in some of those fundamental connections. Black holes become relevant to general relativity because of the singularities that we saw before in the solutions to Einstein's equation. The notes finish off with a little bit of a mention of Hubble and cosmology and how you can use GR equations to talk about an open, flat, or closed universe. So that's my little summary. I hope you didn't find it too intimidating. The intention is not to try and teach you the ins and outs of GR. I wouldn't be able to do that, as I'm no expert on it myself. But maybe you found a little bit of interest in having a look at the topic and what goes into it. And maybe you even feel like learning some of it for yourself. I'll try and leave plenty of resources to do that down in the description. And a little reminder that if you're interested in going to see Sean Carroll talk on his tour and you live in Australia and New Zealand, then head along to Think Inc. and use the code Tibees to get 15% off of some tickets. Thanks for watching.